Hi, my name's Rosalind Bell and welcome to my YouTube channel. If you're new to social media and looking to learn digital life skills, you're in the right place. I'm going to show you how to navigate your way through all the skills you need to learn everything that it has to offer. Today's video is called How to Manage Your Contacts on iPhone, and I'm going to show you how the Contacts application works. Let me show you how to add a contact, amend a contact, and have all your addresses and all your telephone numbers for everybody in your friends and family all on your one device, so you can easily have them all to hand. So at the end of the video, hopefully you can then go and set up your own phone and make sure you've got all your contacts and addresses available to you on your phone. I'm also going to show you at the end of the video how to change your home screen just to make it personalised to you. So let's get into the video. So now let's have a look at our Contacts app on the iPhone. There's two ways of doing it. We can firstly go down to the bottom left, the green iPhone square, and we can click on that to get into our contacts. So it's the middle one at the bottom saying Contacts. Or secondly, we can go to the actual Contacts app. It's the same thing, we get to the same place. So once in our contacts, you'll see at the top right there's a plus sign, so if we click on that it will take us to the contact template screen. So from here our first option is to add a photo, and we can add an emoji if we want, or we can click on all photos to see our photo album and select one of our own. So once we've selected the picture, we can move it around to get it in the right position and choose from the bottom right, and then we can add a filter if we want. Once we've got the right picture in the right place, we just click Done to embed it in the template. So now we just need to start typing in the details. So once you get down to the phone, if you click on the little plus sign to add a phone number, it will automatically give you the default for home. And if you click on home, you can change that to put a mobile number in. So just type in the mobile number, and you can just keep doing that and adding different numbers, a work number, etc. So scrolling down, we then come to the email, and we can do exactly the same there as we did with the phone. We can add the home email, a work email, any other options there available. So then we'll see we have a ringtone, it says default. If you click on that, you'll get other ringtones that you can select on it, and it'll play an example when you click on it. And you can individually select a ringtone for a particular person, so when they ring, you know it's them. You can also do that for a text message. They're sending you a text message, put a special ringtone on, so you know it's them. So scrolling down again, you get to the notes section, and you can add notes onto the template. And once everything's done and you're all filled in, just hit done and it will take you back to the template for that contact. So back into the individual contact. Now you can share a contact. Now, if you had a friend with you and they said to you, by the way, have you got Rosalind Bell's telephone number? You click on share a contact. You can then go down and there's varying different ways you can do it. Now, I love AirDrop. So if the person's standing next to you, you can just click AirDrop. And if you're on Wi-Fi, it will just send them the contact. Or you can message or email or other options. So searching for a contact in your contacts list. If you just click on the search bar at the top, and start typing the person you're looking for. I'm looking for the vet, so you can see I've got two contacts here, and if I just click on the one that I want, it'll bring up its dedicated page. So from here I can message the vet or I can call him just by clicking the blue buttons at the top. So the way I share my contacts is the first name first and the surname second. So I'm going to show you how to personalize that. So if you go back into your settings and look for the contacts and click on that, it will then give you the options, the sort order and the display order. So you can see that's the way I've got mine checked. But if you prefer the last name first, then just make the amendments here in this screen. Now, once you've added all your contacts, you want to have a copy of them on the iCloud. It's very important to keep everything backed up on your phone. So in your settings, scroll back up to the top until you see your name. Once you've clicked on that, you'll now see this screen and you want to go into iCloud. Now Apple gives you 5 gigabytes of free iCloud storage when you buy an iPhone. But you can see here under the iCloud, I've got 50 gigabytes because I've bought more. And the way to do this is go into where it says Manage Storage and click on that, and it will take you into your storage plan. If you click on Change Storage Plan, you can buy more storage. But for the beginning, I think 5 gigabytes is enough. I didn't buy more to start with. And here you will see which apps are actually going up to the iCloud. So your contacts, or my contacts, are on green, which means all my contacts are backed up in the iCloud. So if I were to lose my phone, I could go onto a Mac computer and I could download onto a new phone all my contacts straight from the iCloud. So I won't be missing anything. It's very important that you double check that you've got yours backed up. So now we've learned all about the Contacts app, I thought it might be fun to just show you about the wallpaper on your home screen. You can see this is my home screen here. It's probably easier to see it on this screen here, the picture of my dog, obviously. So back into settings, and you're looking for wallpaper. So click on wallpaper, and that will show you what is your actual home screen page, or you can choose a new one. You can choose it from their selected presets or one of your own. Just scroll down, see if you like any of those, or pick one of your own to use instead. And just double click on it. Then it'll ask you to set it. And they'll give you options, as they always do with Apple. And you can use this screensaver as just to lock the screen, or you can choose to show it as your home screen, or you can set it for both. I normally like to set for both. So I'd click on set for both, and it would automatically input it as my new wallpaper. There you go. I hope you found this video helpful. So now you can go and set up your own iPhone, all your contacts and all the information you need all on your one device. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. And also, any comments that you may have, please put them down below for me and I'll reply to you as soon as I can. I'd love you to subscribe to my channel, and also please hit the notification bell so that next time I upload a video for you to learn with me, you'll be notified. So thanks again for watching, and until next time, bye.